from glory to glory. Lift your hand to heaven, everybody, and begin to wave it to Jesus, giving him the glory for the privilege of standing in his presence again this morning. Our Father, we are grateful, we are thankful, we bless your holy name. You are worthy of all the praise, of all the glory, of all the honor, of all the adoration. Our Father, we have come with gratitude in our hearts. We are grateful, we are thankful, we bless your holy name. You are worthy of all the praise, worthy of all the glory. Thank him for the blessing of standing in his presence. Thank him for the manifestations of his power. We give you the praise and the glory and the honor and the adoration. Blessed be your holy name. Now begin to ask him to speak directly to you. Lord, you have called this our Enough is Enough service. Speak to me this morning. By your word, change my story. By your word, change my level. By your word, open a new chapter to me. Father, in the name of Jesus, I'm set for your word this morning. A word for my change of story. A word for my change of level. A word for the establishment of my liberty. Thank you, mighty God. In the name of Jesus, we have prayed. Our Father, we come before you today. We are grateful for the privilege we have to stand in your presence. For blessed is the man that you choose and cause to approach unto you, that you may fill him with the goodness of your house. We are ready, Lord, to be filled again. You have called today our Enough is Enough service. Let every long-standing issue be brought to an end today. Glorify yourself in our midst. In Jesus' precious name we are praying. Somebody believe God, say the loudest amen. Amen. Give Jesus a big hand, and you may please be seated in the presence of the Lord. Shout glory. We have been looking in this great month at the subject, is there no balm in Gilead? And this is the fourth in the series for the month. Is there no balm in Gilead? And for you, indeed, the balm in Gilead shall manifest himself. It's very important for us to recognize that when we do not know when we are due, we cannot know when we are overdue. When we do not know when we are due, we cannot know when we are overdue. 2,000 years ago, Jesus came and he uttered two very important words. Three words. It is finished. In those three words was the establishment of man's total liberty, particularly for the redeemed. In 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 24, the Bible says, by whose stripes ye were healed. 2,000 years ago, liberty was established. In 2016, you are overdue. Whatever is still hanging around your life that Jesus paid the price for, your liberty is established today. I said your liberty is established today. In Isaiah chapter 54 and verse 14, the Bible makes us to understand, in righteousness shalt thou be established, and thou shalt be far. Say with me, far. Far from oppression, for thou shalt not fear, and also far from terror, for it shall not come near thee. Say with me a loud amen. And 2,000 years ago, Jesus paid the price. to make you and I have access to his righteousness. That is why the Bible said in 2 Corinthians chapter 5 and verse 21, he said, for he had made him to be sin, who knew no sin, that we may be made the righteousness of God in him. So any oppression that is still marking its anniversary in 2016 is overdue. Therefore, today, your liberty is established. I said, today, your liberty is established. In Luke chapter 13 and verse 16, Jesus came across a woman. This woman had been bowed down for 18 solid years. She was overdue for her liberty. And he said, ought not this woman, being a daughter of Abraham, whom Satan has bound, lo, these 18 years, should she not be loosed from this bond? When? On the Sabbath day. Should she not be loosed? Should she not be free? Ought not this woman? And look at what the Bible says in Galatians chapter 4, verse 6 and verse 7. Galatians 4, 6 and 7. He said, and because you are sons, God has sent forth the spirit of his son into your heart, crying, Abba, Father. He said, and wherefore thou art no more a servant. That word servant there means slave, one that is bound. He said, but you are now a son. And if you are a son, you are an heir of God through Christ. It means that slavery is not your portion. Bondage is not your portion. Every force of the wicked that may have kept you bound before today, because you are standing on Mount Zion, you are set free in the name of Jesus. I said you are set free in the name of Jesus. You are set free in the name of Jesus. That is why the Bible said in Zechariah chapter 4 and verse 6 and verse 7, he said, and he answered and said unto me, this is the word of the Lord unto Zerubbabel, saying, not by power nor by might, but by my spirit, saith the Lord. And verse 7, he said, wherefore, who art thou, O great mountain, before Zerubbabel? Thou shalt be made a plain. Thou shalt be made a plain. Thou shalt be made a plain. Every mountain standing before you that has refused to bow to you before now, that has continued to contend with your destiny, today it shall be made a plain. I said, today it shall be made a plain. He said, it's not by power, it's not by might, but it is by my spirit, said the Lord. And when we are redeemed, the Bible said that God sent the spirit of his son into our hearts, whereby we are able to cry, Abba, Father. To every mountain that is still confronting you on this 24th day of July, it shall be made a plain. Everything that has been asking you, who are you? Who are you? Today, as you are standing upon this mountain, you are walking into total liberty. Somebody believe it, say a louder amen. But we come to recognize that entering into a covenant to serve God is what puts an end to the crisis of life. Because serving God guarantees all round rest. In 2 Chronicles chapter 15, in verse 12, they made a covenant to serve God and to seek God with all their heart. And verse 15, the Bible said there, it said, and all Judah rejoiced at the oath. And the result of that oath to serve God is that the Lord gave them rest round about. The Lord gave them rest round about. Every commitment to serve God is the security of divine rest. Every commitment to serve God is the security of divine rest. I had a powerful testimony that just came from last week's service. One of us said that he had this oppression going on. In his house one day, suddenly a bird entered into the house. They struggled running after the bird, trying to kill this bird. Nobody could catch it. And the bird went and rested on one of his sons and suddenly disappeared. He thought nothing of it. Late in the night, by the time he woke up, at 8 o'clock, the boy has not woken up. Tap the boy and he has gone. Another day again, the bird entered the house and rested on the second son, and that son also disappeared. Another day again, the bird came and rested on the wife's stomach, and pregnancy disappeared. And one day, a woman came, the landlady, and sat in front of the house and told him, now that everything is gone, what will you do next? He went to work, lost the job same day, came back and bought a vehicle to be doing transport. The bird entered the vehicle. While they tried to kill the bird with passengers inside, suddenly the vehicle stopped and the vehicle caught fire, burned to ashes. Torment upon torment upon torment. And then one day the lady stood in front of his house and said, I heard you went somewhere. Stop going there. Speaking of Canaan, he said, no, I've made a decision to serve God. Do your worst. He got back home with that anointing of escape. And suddenly, shout glory. The bird entered the house again. It took the oil and dropped it. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. And he said the bird could not enter the room. He began to hear things falling here, right, you know, left and center. By Monday, the family of the woman came and said, why are you trying to kill our mother? He said, no, I'm not trying to kill anybody. I'm simply just serving God. Are you hearing what I'm saying? By the second day, that evil woman had disappeared. Because those who serve God must secure rest. Anyone and anything that has refused to give you rest, today they shall be put to rest. They came and bundled him and took him to the police station. And he got there and said, look, I did not disturb anybody. I simply bowed my knees to pray. And I took this anointing and anointed the room. He said, except your mother is the bed. And the bed died in response to this oil, not my hand. Therefore, I cannot be held liable. The police, you know, the one in charge of the police station looked at him and said, can you also give me some of the oil? Every one of your mockers shall be put to shame. Somebody believe it, say a louder amen. Somebody believe it, say the loudest amen. Therefore, every area of your life where there may have been any oppression of the wicked, as you covenant to serve God, refusing the mockery of the wicked, divine rest shall become your experience. I said divine rest shall become your experience. Divine rest shall become your experience. In the name of Jesus Christ. It's important for us to also recognize that everything that is beyond a night, beyond a while, and beyond a moment is a curse. The Bible tells us very clearly. It says in the book of Psalm chapter 30 and verse 5, weeping may endure for a night. The second night is not permitted. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. In 1 Peter chapter 5 and verse 10, the Bible tells us there very clearly. He said, the God of all grace who had called us to eternal glory by Christ Jesus, after you have suffered a while, make you perfect, establish, strengthen, and settle you. So according to scriptures, it is not permitted beyond the night, it is not permitted beyond the while, and it is not permitted beyond a moment. 2 Corinthians 4:17, he said, for our light affliction, which is but for a moment. So no affliction is permitted by redemption to mark any anniversary in your life. A night must not pass, a while must not pass, and a moment must not pass. Whatever has exceeded that by redemption and by the covenant provision of redemption, your liberty is established now. Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 59, the Bible says to us there, he said, the Lord will make thy plagues wonderful and of long continuance, and sicknesses and of long continuance. Anything that is continuing long is a curse. And the Bible says in Galatians chapter 3 verse 13 and 14, Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for us, for it is written, cursed is everyone that hangeth upon the tree, that the blessing of Abraham may come upon the Gentiles, and that we might receive the promise of the Spirit by faith. Therefore, by redemption, you are excused from curses. Anything, therefore, that represents a long-standing issue in your life, by the power and provision of redemption, your liberty is established in the name of Jesus. He said, there is no enchantment against Jacob. There is no divination against Israel. According to this time, it shall be said of Jacob and Israel, what has God wrought? By redemption, you have become uncursable. Why? Because you and I are spiritual Jews. Romans chapter 2 verse 28 and 29. The Bible says, for he is not a Jew which is one outwardly, neither is that circumcision which is outward in the flesh. He said, but he is a Jew which is one inwardly, and the circumcision that is of the heart, in the spirit and not in the letter, whose praise is not of man but of God. So by redemption, we are made spiritual Jews, which makes us uncursable because we are children of the blessing. Therefore, whatever represents a curse still trying to hang around any individual's life, today marks the end of it in the name of Jesus. I said today marks the end of it in the name of Jesus. However, we are also made to see from scriptures that serving God is what entitles us to the continuous flow of his blessings. Serving God is what entitles us to the continuous flow of his blessings. It's Exodus chapter 23 verse 25 and 26. You shall serve the Lord your God. He shall bless your bread and your water. He will take sickness away from the midst of thee. He said, the number of your days you fulfill, and you will not cast your young nor be barren in the land. Furthermore, we are made to see from scriptures that prophets are agents of liberty. They are agents of enough is enough on the earth. Therefore, whatever has been hanging around, which you have become tired of, by the prophetic word which God will release shortly through his servant, your liberty shall be totally established. It was by a prophet the Lord brought the entire nation of Israel out of Egypt. Therefore, by a prophet this morning, there shall be liberty for everyone in this service. But we discover that one of the great prescriptions of the great physician for our liberty is the name of Jesus. The name of Jesus. The name of Jesus. It carries capacity for healing. It carries capacity for deliverance. It carries capacity for liberty. But the question is, what is in that name that sets free? What is that name loaded with that sets free? We'll see a few things very quickly from God's word, and then each one of us will be walking gallantly into our liberty. Number one, the name of Jesus is the irrevocable gift of God for our dominion. The name of Jesus is the irrevocable gift of God for our dominion. Philippians chapter 2 verse 9 down to verse 11. He said, wherefore God has highly exalted him and given him a name that is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, of things in heaven, of things in the earth, and of things under the earth. In the name, angels respond. In the name, situations on earth turn. In the name, demons are brought down. Everything in heaven, everything on earth, and everything under the earth responds to the name. The name therefore becomes our ultimate access to divine dominion. Our ultimate access to divine dominion. In the book of John chapter 5 verse 20 and verse 21, the Bible makes us to understand, it says, for the Father loveth the Son and showeth him all things that himself doeth. He will show him greater works than these that you may marvel. He said, and for as the Father raised the dead and quickened them, even so the Son quickeneth whom he will. Whatever the Father is doing, the Son is also in command of. And the name is our access to committing the person of the Son for our dominion. Shout hallelujah. I said shout hallelujah. I said shout hallelujah. So the name of Jesus is our access to dominion. It's our access to dominion. It's our access to dominion. That is why whenever any force wants to come to suppress you, you can cry out in the name of Jesus. And suddenly that which wanted to be over you comes under you. Because the name of Jesus is our access to dominion. Today, whatever was trying to lord it over you, as you cry in that name, your dominion shall be established. Number two, what is in that name? The anointing of Christ, the anointed one, resides in the name. The anointing of Christ, the anointed one himself, resides in the name. In Songs of Solomon chapter 1 verse 3, he said, thy name is as ointment poured forth. He said, therefore do the virgins love thee. Thy name is as ointment. It's as ointment. When I'm mentioning the name, I'm releasing the anointing of Jesus. And what is the capacity of that anointing? John chapter 3 verse 34. He said, and the one whom the Father sendeth, he said, God giveth him not the spirit by measure. It is a measureless anointing. An anointing without limitation. An anointing without restriction. Whenever you are faced with anything that looks like it is more than you, it is not more than him. And therefore, when you engage the name, that anointing overwhelms that restriction. Therefore, today, as the name is engaged, the anointing of Jesus shall answer on your behalf. The Bible makes us to understand very clearly concerning this great name of Jesus in Acts chapter 4 verse 9 and verse 10. The Bible says concerning the man who was healed from at the gate called Beautiful, if this day will be examined of the good deed done to the impotent man, by what means he is made whole. Look at what he says. Let it be known to you and to all the people of Israel that by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, he said, whom ye crucified, whom God raised from the dead, even by him. Even by him. When I mention the name, it is not just a name detached from the personality. When the name is mentioned, Jesus himself is the one who manifests. And that is why the anointing on him is the one that answers. How do I know? In Acts chapter 9 verse 33 to 35, Peter was going through the city of Lydda, and the Bible said there was a man called Aeneas. He had kept his bed for 8 years and was sick with the palsy. And look at what he said. And Peter said unto him, Aeneas, Jesus Christ maketh thee whole. In other words, as I'm calling his name, he's answering. Jesus Christ maketh thee whole.
As I'm calling his name, the unction on his life is answering. Jesus Christ maketh thee whole. Don't look at Peter, look at Jesus. Are you hearing what I'm saying this morning? I have good news for you. This morning, as you are mentioning the name, Jesus himself is appearing for your liberty. I said Jesus himself is appearing for your liberty. And what does that anointing that is on Jesus do? Number one, that anointing heals. That anointing heals. It is an anointing that secures healing. An anointing that secures healing. We saw it in the story of that man at the gate called Beautiful in Acts chapter 3 verse 16. The Bible says there, Acts chapter 3 verse 16, concerning him, he said, and in his name, through faith in his name, had this man been made strong, whom you see and know. Yea, the faith which is by him had given him this perfect soundness in the presence of you all. I don't know how you came to this service this morning, but what I know is that by the time you are departing with perfect soundness. Because at the mention of the name, soundness shall be restored to your body. I said soundness shall be restored to your body. I said soundness shall be restored to your body. If you believe it, say a louder amen. Number two, at the mention of that name, demons are cast out. It is an anointing that casts out demons. An anointing that casts out demons. The Bible says in the book of Luke chapter 10 and verse 17, it said, they returned with joy, saying that in thy name the devils were subject unto us. The devils were subject. The devils were subject. Demons were cast out. He said in the book of Mark chapter 16 and verse 17, these signs shall follow them that believe. In my name they shall cast out devils. I don't know what is tormenting your body. Maybe there are moving objects going around your system. Maybe there is internal heat that cannot be diagnosed. You find all kinds of oppressions in the night, in the day, whatever it is. But as you mention the name, today, every stranger, every demon, everything that is tormenting your body shall disappear in a moment. Somebody believe it, say louder, amen. So when I cry in the name of Jesus, what I'm doing is casting out devils. Because the name casts out devils. It doesn't matter how long that torment may have been and the personality that is behind it. But as the name is mentioned, every devil shall be cast out. Amen. Somebody believe it, say louder, amen. Amen. I said somebody believe it, say louder, amen. Amen. Somebody believe it, say the loudest, amen. Number three thing we see is that when the sick is anointed with oil in that name, the Bible said they are healed. So even the anointing oil responds to the name of Jesus. James chapter 5 verse 14 and verse 15. Is any sick among you? Let him call for the elders of the church. Let them pray over him, anointing him with oil in the name of the Lord. And the prayer of faith shall save the sick, and the Lord shall raise him up. The one whom they called is the one who will raise. Every time you engage the anointing, it is by the name of Jesus that it is provoked to answer. For somebody here, every time you engage the anointing shall answer by his name. In the name of Jesus Christ. Number four, the name of Jesus is our key to deliverance. It is our key to deliverance. Proverbs chapter 18 and verse 10. He said, the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous runneth into it and they are safe. He runneth into it and they are safe. There is no time the name is mentioned that safety is not secured. There is no time the name is mentioned that safety is not secured. So the name of Jesus is our key to deliverance from every assault of the wicked. As you mention his name today, as you breathe his name today, as you cry his name today, everything that was an assailant of your destiny, your safety from them is established. And finally, number five, we see that our prayers are answered through the name of Jesus. Our prayers are answered through the name of Jesus. Our prayers are answered through the name of Jesus. In John chapter 14, verse 12 to 14, the Bible says to us, the works that I do, shall you do also. And greater works than these shall you do, because I go to my Father. He said, and whatsoever ye shall ask in my name, that will I do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. And verse 14, if you ask anything in my name, I will do it. So there is nothing you cry in his name that he will not do. Every time we call on him, engage in his name, he has guaranteed that he will act. Shout hallelujah. I say shout hallelujah. Therefore, this morning, we are going to have the privilege to engage the name, to cry enough is enough against every challenge and every assailant. You may have come here with terminal diseases, but it can be terminated by the name. Somebody believe it, say a loud amen. Amen. You may have come here with torment in your body, but it can be terminated by the name. You may have come here being oppressed by demons and devils, but they can be cast out by the name. Maybe there are manipulators and enchanters, like what's happening against the brother in that testimony, but by the name, judgment can be secured. The name of Jesus is sufficient for our total liberty. For you today, liberty shall be established. But I'd like us to understand this very important truth from scriptures. The Bible says in Psalm chapter 56 and verse 9, it said, when I cry, then shall my enemies turn back. This I know, for God is for me. In the book of 2 Chronicles chapter 32 and verse 20, look at what the Bible says. It says, start from verse 19. It says there, and they spake against the God of Jerusalem as against the gods of the people of the earth, which were the work of the hands of men. And look at verse 20. And for this cause, Ezekiah the king and the prophet Isaiah, the son of Amos, prayed. And what did he do next? And cried. You see, prayer secures intervention. A cry secures instant intervention. They prayed and they cried. What was the result? In verse 21, and the Lord sent an angel which cut off the mighty men of valor and the leaders and the captains in the camp and of the king of Assyria, and he returned with shame of face to his own land. Whatever was pursuing to destroy you shall turn with shame of face. But what did they do? They prayed and they cried. When Bartimaeus saw Jesus, he didn't just call him, he cried. Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy on me. They tried to shut him down, and the Bible said, he cried yet the louder. Today you are going to have the opportunity to cry. Lord, I'm not praying because this one will not be delayed. I'm crying. I'm transitioning from praying to crying because my intervention must happen now. Say me, it must happen now. Louder like you mean it, it must happen now. Like you are sure about it, it must happen now. He said, for now is the time, and now is the day. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Now is the accepted time, and now is the day of salvation. Now, 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 now is the time. Now is the day. But that instant nature answers to a cry. In 2 Chronicles chapter 18 verse 31, the Bible said that the enemy surrounded Jehoshaphat to destroy him. He said, but Jehoshaphat cried out, and the Lord helped him, and God moved them to depart from him. Whatever was moving to inflict you shall be moved to depart from you. Whatever was moving to afflict you shall be moved to depart from you. Therefore, what am I saying this morning? In a moment, we are going to have the privilege of a cry. We are going to have the privilege of what? Of a cry. But I want to show you a secret that will ignite your faith. Look at that scripture again. 2 Chronicles chapter 32 and verse 20. Look at it. It says, Hezekiah the king and the prophet Isaiah. You may be an individual, but the cry and the declarations will be led by a prophet. When the people and the prophet lifted their voice, God had to answer. Maybe there are things that have not responded to you yet, but today, as the cry is led by a prophet of God to this generation, what did not answer you alone will answer you today. Is somebody hearing what I'm saying today? What is God telling us? Today, that situation must expire. Today, that circumstance must come to an end. Today, that torment must be brought to an end. Today, enough is enough. I said, today, enough is enough. I said, today, enough is enough. Every situation is turned to a testimony today. Lift your right hand to heaven and give God the glory. Give him the glory. Father, we thank you. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed. In a moment, before we are led in this cry for our liberty, wherever you are, if you are not born again, you are not a child of God, you are not connected to God, you don't have the assurance of salvation in your heart, today is your opportunity. Wherever you are, in the tabernacle, in the overflows, you want to surrender your life to Jesus, I want you to quickly rise on your feet. Quickly rise on your feet. Today is your day. God brought you for that purpose. Quickly. Quickly rise on your feet. Quickly rise on your feet. Jesus brought you just for that purpose. Very quickly. I want to be born again. I want to make Jesus the Lord of my life. Quickly rise on your feet. Also, there are those who are here who need to rededicate their lives to Jesus. You have been born again. You have walked with God in the past, but somewhere along the line, you missed it. You went off course. You want to return so that you can be restored. You want to be part of God's family again. Jesus is calling upon you. Also, you want to rededicate your life. Rise on your feet. You want to rededicate your life to Jesus. I want to pray with you. You'll be set free. Your liberty will be established. Quickly rise on your feet. And if you have done that in the first and second call, make your way to the aisle that is closest to you. Make your way to the aisle that is closest to you. Officials, please help them. Make your way to the aisle closest to you. Our officials will be there to guide you. Quickly do that. God bless you. God bless you. People of God, give Jesus a big hand of praise. Thank you, Lord. If you have done that right now, quickly lift up your right hand, suspend feeling your form and lift up your right hand. I want you to pray this prayer after me from the depth of your heart and do it with faith. Say after me, Lord Jesus, I come to you today. I know that I'm a sinner, but I know you died for me and on the third day you rose again. Jesus, come into my life. Be my Lord and Savior. Take control of me from this day forward. Now I know that I am born again. Thank you, Lord, for saving me. In Jesus' name, amen. I pray for you, Father, in the name of Jesus. Let the grace that has brought these precious ones keep them to the day of your coming. We decree concerning them that none shall return back to their vomit. In the name of Jesus. Grace to stand. Grace to run this race with dignity and finish winning the prize. Release it upon them in Jesus' name. Thank you, mighty God. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed. Somebody believe, say a loud amen. Amen. Please ensure that your forms are completed. Everyone who has responded to that call and return it to the officials, be blessed. Is somebody ready to walk into liberty right now? Rise on your feet and give Jesus a big hand as we receive our Father to take us forward.
Hallelujah. The divine body of enough is enough shall be fully executed in your life today. Look at that issue that's been staring you in the face over the years. Call it by name to Jesus and invoke the enough is enough verdict of faith on it and walk into your liberty forever. The siege on your spiritual life is over today. The siege on your family, your children, your spouse is over today. The siege on your business and career is over today. You call it by name, enough is enough. In the name of Jesus Christ. Because there is dominion virtue in that name. There is healing virtue in that name. There is breakthrough virtue in that name. There is deliverance virtue in that name. In a moment, with your faith alive, you call it by name and tell that devil, in the name of Jesus Christ, enough is enough of your hold on my life. You tell that sickness and disease, enough is enough on your hold on my life. Jerusalem. The Rodello Precanaro Sasenabura. Enough is enough. Enclacarada to Pretello Radis de Rotapa. Enough is enough. Apeco Takero Berisa Corade. Ebra Dagradada Rado Zise. Enough is enough. Epambala Barade Sopra Radeza. Enough is enough. Ekrakato Kraktanaro Deso. Enough is enough. Beboriale Kradakarato Siso. Enough is enough. Okla Gara Dakoni Teprona. Yetosa Zero Tabe. Geronda Kata Suse. Enough is enough. Ebrabano. Brablo Bradavo. Zebro Delo Bredia. Yeplorodazia. Barade Koradiza. Eplo precano tano, desira de precano. Enough is enough. Baketo ke, to the siege of barrenness, enough is enough. Breketo rialeba, to every generation accord, enough is enough. Breketo aletagala, to the cause of the wicked, enough is enough. Bredika rato zizara, to every siege of terminal disease, enough is enough. To every siege of untimely death, enough is enough. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' precious name, we are praying. In the name of Jesus, we are praying. I'd like you in a moment to remove your shoes off your feet. And let your feet be firmly on this prophetic ground. There is something about this place. One of us came in here in 1999. Jesus raised him from being a cripple after 23 years. She turned 60 last year and walked with dignity on this platform by herself. Liberated on this ground. Now listen to me. With your feet firmly on ground today, every siege of long continuance is a time declared over today. Somebody was brought here or came down here from Germany. Deported. Straight from hospital. As he got to the gate here of this Hope entrance, Where's the toilet? What they could not help him to do medically poured out on this ground by itself. Whatever has been held down by the devil standing on this ground today brings an end to it forever. A man had traveled outside, inside, looking for green pasture, no headway. Came in Johnny Shiloh and slept on this ground, and they find two dead birds under their pillow. And the siege ended. Whatever has pursued you to this place has brought an end to that siege in your life. You hear what that evil woman say? Stop going to that place. Stop going to that place. And as he brought the oil of escape back there and splashed the ground with that oil, the evil woman died. Whatever has been pursuing you that pursued to this ground goes down for you today. At the base of this ministry shall be built a 50,000 sanctuary. He said that 1982. And 1997, he said, this is the place. Now, what does that mean? The hour has come to liberate you from all oppressions of the devil. Therefore, every oppression of the devil on any area of your life is over today. That man came in for 15 years. He couldn't sleep without drugs. 15 years. He has thrown away the drugs after that impartation service. It ended there. Now he sleeps like a baby. 15 years of ordeal came to an end. 31 years of unending cough came to an end. Enough is enough. Every torture and torment on your life, enough is enough. In the name of Jesus. Enough is enough on that marital delay. Enough is enough on the plague of barrenness. Enough is enough on business and career stagnation. 2 people got miracle jobs in the second service. The calls came in right there. Now, this week, your enough is enough testimony with your miracle job is settled. Enough is enough is settled in your life today. Your search for miracle children is settled today. Your search for marital restoration is settled today. Every evil board that is landing on your lot, your children, your business, your spouse, enough is enough. Of every satanic oppression. Enough is enough of every satanic oppression. Enough is enough of every satanic oppression. Enough is enough of every satanic oppression. Now, receive your miracle children. Receive your miracle marriage. Receive your miracle jobs. Receive your supernatural breakthroughs. Business and career breakthroughs. Be made whole now. Be made whole now. I command every terminal disease terminated in your life. Somebody was taking 20 tablets a day. Jesus, same thing, free like a dream of the night. Therefore, in the name of Jesus, everything tormenting you, making you a victim of medication, comes to an end in your life today. In the name of Jesus. So shall it be. Thank you, Father. How many are ready for their instant healing? Now, put your hand on any part of your body that carries any form of affliction. Your eyes, your ears. In the second service, we had a three-year-old girl that had an accident and had not walked ever since, walked today. We had a six-year-old boy that has never had 2 ears deaf, he had this morning. Therefore, in the name of Jesus the Christ, receive your instant healings now. I command your eyes and ears to be open in the name of Jesus. I command the tongue of the deaf to be loosed in the name of Jesus. Command every blood disease terminated right now. I curse every form of cancer in the name of Jesus Christ. I curse every oppression of the devil on your family. Now be made whole in the name of Jesus. Tuberculosis is cursed in the name of Jesus. Barrenness is cursed in the name of Jesus. Every failing organ in your body bounces back to life right now. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your name. Come on, let me hear you say, I'm healed. Let me hear you say, I'm set free. Free at last. I am free forever. We are going to be singing his praise. Everyone who has been touched by the power of God, make your way down here. We celebrate God with you as we close in this service. As this praise is going on, everyone who has been touched by the healing power of God, everyone who has been delivered by the power of God, just jump down here. Check your system. The growth is gone. Check your system. Everything you could not do before, begin to do them right now. Come on, put on your shoes. And as soon as this song begins, everyone that has been taught by the power of God, just come down here. We wave our hands to heaven on your behalf, and then we go home. He said, go and show yourself to the priest. You mustn't hide God's healing in your life so you don't have it in your core again. Every time you show yourself, he perfects his hand on your life. Come on now, let's praise him.
Have you heard what the Lord has done? He has destroyed the world of Satan. He has given us victory. That's why we say, oh, say yeah. Have you heard what the Lord has done? He has destroyed the works of Satan. He has given us victory. That's why we say, oh, say yeah. Oh, say yeah. Have you heard what the Lord has done? He has destroyed the works of Satan. He has given us victory. That's what we say. Oh, say it again. Oh, have you heard what the Lord has done? He has destroyed the works of Satan. He has given us. That's what we say. Oh, say it. We say, oh, say it.
Everybody, give God thanks for your own encounter today. Enough is enough has become your testimony. This week is declared your week of is enough order of testimonies in all ramifications. Blessed be your name, Jesus. Thank you and thank you and thank you. In Jesus' precious name. For all these instant testimonies that are out here in front, give the Lord a big hand of praise. Please be seated for 2 minutes. Let's take a few of these testimonies right now. Amen.
Shout glory. Akosim Raymond, 10 years of watery discharge from the anus, dried up right now.
Amen.
By the power of God. Brahma Yakubu. Impotency and partial deafness, both destroyed right now in God's presence.
Let him come. Who is that person? Come quickly. Amen. Jesus is in the house. He's setting free every captive. Whatever chains came with you into this service has dropped off you right now.
St. Isaac, 20 years moving object disappeared from his body now. Breakthrough.
Mercy. You hear your name, just come up quickly. Come up quickly right now.
Johnson Isaac.
Johnson Isaac. Quick.
Breakthrough, John. 21 years stone-like object in the heart disappeared right now.
Come on, give the Lord a big hand. If you're that one, come up quickly.
Jonathan Uzoma, 5 years dislocated shoulder fixed instantly here in God's presence.
Amen. Where is he? Amen. The master surgeon is in the house.
Edun Jobi and Anoluakbo, 23 years hernia instantly healed right now in God's presence. Mama Modukwe had intense pain. She's 82 years, could not walk without a walking stick, but right now she has dropped the walking stick. Woo! Jesus has set her free.
Hallelujah.
Come on, shout.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. How old is she?
Amen.
How old is she?
Sylvester.
Huh? 82-year-old young girl. Hallelujah. Amen. We don't grow old as winners. I saw a young lady last Sunday, 106-year-old, there at my office area. Amen.
Amen.
Can you see her jumping? Jesus has healed her completely. Amen.
Hallelujah. Gomez Michael, he said, right now, he has been jobless for 1 year, but right now he got a miracle job alert.
Amen. Where is he?
Gomez Michael.
Got a job right there as the world was going on.
Hallelujah. Edit Eze, 3 years spiritual husband disappeared from her system right now, and ulcer pains also disappeared this moment.
3 years spiritual husband has found his way back to her.
Amen. Samuel Mercy, hip and joint pain for 7 months, healed right now in God's presence.
Amen. Shall we all rise? Too many exciting testimony. Come on, give the Lord a shout. Give him a shout of victory. The battle is over. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' precious name. Amen. Too many testimonies out here in front. To God alone be all the glory. Go in peace. Every encounter today is declared permanent. The week is declared your week of enough is enough order of testimony. Whatever has been stagnated in your life has now been released. Your glorious destiny has now been released. Your marital destiny has now been released. Your family destiny is now released. Your business and career is now released. Your total health is finally restored. Your total health is finally restored. In the name of Jesus Christ. I believe by now you all got flyers of next Sunday's special miracle service. Endeavor to ensure that at least one soul, brand new soul, comes along with you next Sunday. And watch what the Lord does with you. This is our last week of Operation 6678. So put your best into this last week so you can reap the best of what God has in store. The good news is this shall be your best year to date in your life. This year shall be the best to date in your life. And every year from henceforth shall be a plus on the previous. Together, let's share the goodness of the Lord in fellowship, everybody. God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the presence of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. From glory to glory. and from glory to glory. We are all getting there. Congratulate 1, 2, 3 people there. Congratulations, the battle is over. Congratulations, the battle is over. Congratulations, the battle is over. Glory! Let's move on with speed so as to give room to the fourth service.